Welcome once again, all of you here from the university and visitors to the university through this program. And I'm happy to be flanked by two panelists who are experts in their own way, grown in their own way, come here very sincerely at the invitation to share their experiences. And an event like this, in the inaugural session, it was told that the university was keen to have a round table on law as compared to the several round tables it had earlier, and very important knowledge sectors that the university has undertaken to deal with. And I suppose over a period of time, this round table in law will take deep roots and invite greater attention and involvement of greater number of people, not only from the field of law, but from a very interactive engagement of the relevance of enhancing quality and relevant legal education in contemporary times. In the inaugural session, some of the broader issues which are confronting the Indian legal community today, both lawyers, judges, institutions, parliamentarians and the community. And in the context of bridging law and technology. Now when we, some of us, too, because that we are here as part of the host, the UPES, when Mr. Suri, myself and Sadhana were invited to become part of the advisory council for the School of Law in UPES, we were not too sure what we were called upon to do. But when we grew ourselves, I think I should say, we grew with the university in learning more about the contents of legal education in contemporary India. While I, having been associated with Professor Madhav Menon since 1986 in the Bangalore Law School program, and ever since thereafter, wherever he has been going and experimenting, and part of his various other legal education initiatives, and which has generated in me an interest in understanding the contours of legal education in our country. And I'm deeply concerned about it, not only as an individual, but as part of the legal community. And my little experience in working in the Law Commission over two terms, while looking at the engagement of our institutions of governance and our institutions of knowledge imparting, particularly legal education institutions, I think there is a greater need for a variety of sectors of people to come together in a common platform. And while we are talking about what is probably afflicting legal education in India today, I think the problems are universal. I have been looking at very closely, studying and understanding what's happening in legal education in the rest of the world. And we'll have two important panelists to share their experience. I just want to flag off some broader concerns and comparisons. So it is not as if that the problems afflicting legal education are unique to India, and we are anyway backward in our thinking. Not that we have been able to comprehend the problems like others have been able to do. Like a very well-known academic in USA who taught in Yale and Columbia, and continues to teach in Columbia, Professor Brian Tamana, wrote an important book called Failing Law Schools. And he was talking about legal education in USA. And as I read the book, I thought what he's writing is probably more opposite to what's happening in India. And I wrote back to him and saying that this is my impression. He said, perhaps what I wrote is only relevant for USA and Japan, but I'm surprised to know that a country like India thinks that it has relevance to an Indian subcontinent. And he has generated debate in USA. And as I read a recent article in 2015, the American Bar Association is now talking about setting in motion very important and radical changes in the legal education in USA. President Barack Obama thought about probably having a two-year course and a third-year course of the legal education program to deal exclusively with skills training. And there are a lot of discussions and debates going on there. And if you look at the European continent, and whether it's Spain or Germany or Italy or any of the new, old Soviet bloc countries, including Russia, and they're all talking about some universal models of legal education which can deal with both problems of justice with equity and problems of justice administration with modern contemporary needs, with a wide range of complex issues which we have thrown open to ourselves. And therefore, it's not that we are in an exclusive, isolated area, but there are some of these universal features which are confronting human beings everywhere. So I think, therefore, what we are going to learn today from this panelists and in the afternoons would be to broadly have some comparisons and to ensure that the university, UPES, would learn not only for itself, but be able to, arrange a leadership program in due course of time for the entire legal education in our country. And there are a lot of debates going on at the National Law School level. The Vice Chancellors are meeting very often. We have the National Association of Law Teachers, which has become largely defunct and which needs to be rejuvenated. And I suppose if this initiative is able to lead to a standing conference on initiatives in legal education which UPS can host over a period of time, probably we'll be able to see a lot of good emerging thinking and experiments and actual work on the field. As somebody said, learning and innovation go on hand in hand. And the arrogance of success lies in thinking that what we did yesterday is sufficient for tomorrow. But I think that's where we have to turn new chapters. So I am really happy today that Mr. Jyoti Sagar has been able to come and share with us his experiences, a very long experience he has. And but suppose with the introductions we had today, the forenoon, and the background of the university he had, I'm sure he'll be able to share with us a lot of information which go on a structured basis to take on to the next stage. I welcome you, Mr. Jyoti Sagar. Please enlighten with your views.